season almost come unravelled last week as Ulster failed to get the points against their closest rival in the pool, the Leicester Tigers. Now they face an uphill battle where they need maximum points and they need them quickly. And they start that off versus Montpellier today in round 5 of the Heineken Cup. Hello everyone and welcome along to Cornflakes Crib, your home of Rugby Challenge 2 and the Heineken Cup, where we are into the 5th group pool match, and it is Montpellier hosting Ulster, who are really on the brink here, but we'll get to them in a minute. Montpellier, on the other hand, aren't all but out of the competition. Of course, it is the second place teams that can pick up a spot in the next round if they are one of the top sides, but they have to compete. Well, they need to win today. That is really cut and dry what it is for Montpellier. Their recent form, they went down to the Tigers 28-18 a couple of weeks ago. There'll be 2 rounds to go, and then last round they did the double over Treviso. As you'd expect, the bottom place team getting thumped 34-18, and that keeps Montpellier in the hunt, but they need to score a lot of points here today. And, well, Ulster are in the same boat, really. And the Formax has chopped a lot of the squad off, too. They've suffered a bit of pain in the back line, and we'll get to that in a second. Of course, if you've been tuning in last week, in round 4, the second reverse round, the Tigers getting revenge for their round 1 loss, beating Ulster 6-0. Thanks to just 2 penalties from Flood. Of course, before that, the Ulster side were unbeaten with wins over the Tigers in round 1. 17-5, they beat Montpellier in the first fixture between these two sides, and 22-7, they beat Treviso in round 3. So the change is going through. Henderson in the second row is the change coming in the back. That's the only change in the forwards, because it's the back line that this Ulster team are really gifted in. It's where 11, 13, 15 is a chain. Is our Trimble coming in on the left wing for Gilroy, who missed out on so many opportunities in the last round. Payne coming in from fullback to the outside centre, and he is replaced at fullback from Andrew. So that sees Cave depart. Marshall lucky to keep a spot, but not too many wholesale changes going on, but something of an opportunity for players like Trimble and Andrew to get some points and maybe secure them that spot if they can perform. But it is 5 points needed here from Ulster. They need to really come out firing today. It will be Ulster to kick off through Jackson. Ulster playing in their home strip of the red and white, and Montpellier in the blue and black as we are underway, and it's kicked off straight down the throat of the man on the right wing who really haunted them last week, or last round, last fixture between these two sides, Nagasa. He was really outstanding on that right side. Here he is again. It's Nagusa. Get it right. This time he's in a bit of strife, and he's turned over from Doyle. Now it's chance for Ulster. They could get a try very early on. We've got a great way for their cause. They have to watch that man. Nagusa on the right wing. Now I've sorted myself out. They go away for Marshall. Marshall splits him in half. He's going for the corner, Marshall. Bowe's coming across to assist, but the pass goes through the face of Rennie Ranger and into touch. Almost what could have been a blowing chance already for Ulster. And, wow, that could have been a try inside 5 minutes. Ivaldi will have the line-out. Goes to the back and it's stolen from Doyle. Here comes Pinar trying to go himself. Williams to Ferris, Best, he won't get there. Marshall, Payne, looks wide. Trimble, chance for the new man, can't get in there. And it's a good tackle from the man we've already mentioned as a threat. And Nasuga doing the job on defense now. Henderson, Best, popping it up for Marshall. Can Marshall get there? He does. Great try, 10 minutes on the board. Ulster lead 5-0. That is what they wanted, a try early on. And it is Marshall, the man who's looked very good already, gets them their first try. Well done too. Spectacularly done. Ferris involved there. Everyone was involved. Best over the top. Nice work. Marshall in the tackle. Seemed to be an offside player as well. Advantage was called. But it didn't matter. They got the job done. They got over for the try. And Ron Pienaar had the chance to make a 7. Of course, first and foremost, winning this match is the most important thing. Lose here today and their season may possibly well be finished. The kick is good from Pienaar. And we have a 7-0 scoreline. Ulster looking a bit better already today. Trunduk has the ball on halfway. He'll kick us off. Dangerous man with the ball in hand is Trunduk. He kicks away up towards halfway. And it is Doyle. Man who got the turnover. Gets it away. And Henderson. Oh, not the best pass. A chance already. This could be a try straight back from Montpellier. But it is dived on. And that was Pelisi. What a start that could have been off the kickoff. Oh, I'm surprised he didn't go himself. That is a close run thing almost instantly. Montpellier reply. They run the back of the 22 dropout and they spread it to the left side. Good passing, giving them the opportunity for Ranger. He's taken eventually from Best.
Release.
And Ulster try and put some pressure on the ruck. Nothing coming back. And it's Ebersson who pops up a short pass to Trunduk. Now they look to the centres.
Release.
Trying to get the ball here, Ulster. Figalo, good pass, there's spaces, there's gaps, and it's Mass. He goes wide, it's Pienaar in a chase for the danger man. No, and it's a day, he's in again. Goodness me, Nagusa scores, and he is troubling the Ulster side almost instantly. Oh, Nagusa, he is a superstar. But it was the run from Mass that really put the trouble on. Pienaar had the task, he couldn't get there, he was never going to catch him for pace. And Nagusa. Outstanding work from the big prop, Druin Trimble. And then the chase coming across. Andrew. Pienaar. No chance, Nagusa scores. And a great response. After almost getting it straight away, they've had to rely on the Superman on the right wing. Trunduk will make it 7. From the right, he hits it. It's looking on the pole. It slithers wide. And he won't make it 7. Put the mockers on him there. 7-5, Ulster still hold a slender lead over Montpellier. Well, that will make them disappointed, Ulster. They got off to a flyer. And just 10 minutes after they scored, they've been hit back as the kickoff is going down. Oh, brilliantly, Nagusa's got the ball again. He's popped it inside for Guinemo. And it's turnover from Jackson. The young fly half doing the job in the rucks now for them. Can they hang on here? Oh, no, they can't. Good work from Montpellier in the ruck, turning the ball over. It's a big locks combining. Oh, Nagusa, he's through again. This time he kicks. Andrew's got a chase, it's holding up in the wind. Where's it gonna go? He can't let this dive. Oh, that was close. And Andrew kicks it dead. But Nagusa is crouch. Just outstanding.
Crouch.
Oh, that was put into goal from Montpellier. That should definitely be a 22. Well, I don't know about that. The rules here, into goal from the kick. But it is a scrum regardless. Pelisi, he goes to the danger man. Nagusa pops it into Ferris. Ferris just about gets away. Somewhat stumbled after his intercept. But they're going to lose out on the ball already, Ulster. It is Wedrago. Who has a go now? It's Gamino. Going with some short plays. Oh, good work. Trimble gets it away. Jackson, oh my goodness, no one's home. What a mistake from Ulster. What was he thinking? He has just gifted a try to that danger man, Nagusa. Oh, goodness me, how do you butcher that? Jackson has a mind explosion. They did well. They gave it to him. But the pressure from the attack on him, the defensive pressure, he just lost the plot and he just threw it out the back door. Oh, that is unbelievable. Nagusa gets a gift and he grabs a double. What an outstanding play. Knowing, taking that opportunity from a mistake. But how will Jackson be feeling now? What a mistake as we head towards halftime. Tronduk has another shot from a similar spot. This time makes no mistake, and we are 12-7. Montpellier leading. And Ulster, well, could be falling away out of the Heineken Cup. They need to regather this kick. And they need to score a try before half time. That is really what they need to do. Again, it's taken from the Goosa. The man is outstanding. He is in everything, and now he's been penalised. So you say he's been outstanding, but there we go. He makes a mistake. He is human. And 37 minutes gone. They have no option here but to tap and go. Jackson will run it at the line. Good ball to Henderson. The big lock. Henderson rumbling through the middle. Afoa on his shoulder. Good work from the big prop. Here's Pienaar. Pienaar. Oh, Pienaar's through. Dummying. Oh, he had numbers on his right. Couldn't give it to them. The buzzer goes. Popped up. Oh, that is a wasted chance. And Polisi kicks it into touch. Wow. That is amazing. Ulster have blown another chance to score the try. Ruan Pienaar went so close. But really, should have looked to the outside. Halftime stats. Ulster are really just about dead and buried here. They need that 5 points to keep themselves alive. They've only had 37% of the ball. They've shared territory evenly, but made a 3 pathetic line breaks compared to Montpellier's 5. Handling errors are 4, but it's just affecting their game far too much here. They need 3 tries in the second spell. They really needed to score one before half time. They went so close, but just couldn't finish the job. In the end, Montpellier hold a 5-point lead at half time. And with 40 minutes to go, let's crack back down to the action. Second 40 of round 5 of the Heineken Cup. Do or die for one of these teams here. Could be saying goodbye to the Heineken Cup dream. With still a match to play. Tronduk was just getting going too in that first half. He was having a couple of little scampers with the ball. And he kicks off. Ferris picks up nicely to Bow. Bow has just been dominated out there.
Release.
Easily dealt with from Ranger. Pienaar to Marshall, who was good in the early goings. A brilliant ball to Payne. This is the chance they need. Can the pass go to Trimble? It does. It's a chase between Trimble and Flock, but he gets it done, Trimble. Brilliantly done. It was a simple play of numbers, but the finish was there. The finish was immaculate, and the pass was pinpoint. Trimble getting the try, and Ulster right back in this match. It was led by Marshall. Oh, he really monstered his man too. It's just about a mistake there from Payne, not drawing in the fullback, but the pass was good. So maybe if he drew in that tackle, he could have butchered the pass. Just that little delay there from the fullback was enough to put Trimble in the space. And we have a game on our hands here. Ulster know what needs to be done. And it's up to them to do it. They've got 2 tries. Can they look for 2 more? The conversion attempt, always important, as it is 12-0. Pienaar hits it nicely, flat one, hits the wind nicely, through the sticks, we're 14-12. Ulster take back the lead. Oh, such a cool, collected player. Ruan Pienaar, experience coming out his ears. Such a key element for this Ulster side. So 5 minutes after half time, Tronduk finds himself back at halfway kicking off. And that's exactly what the Ulster doctor ordered. Payne has dropped that. Jackson's had to go back and clean it up. Doyle pops it up for Bow. Now Bow puts on a fan, gets rid of one, can't get another going, and it's turned over. So that's disappointing play. Big holes in midfield too here. Oh, and a high tackle coming in from Marshall on his opposite number, Oliver. And this could give Montpellier the lead if they want to have a shot at goal here. Tronduk would be keen, surely. Oh, wow. No. Montpellier want the bonus point as well. Oh, this is interesting. Neither side wanting three, because they know their season lies on four tries. This is a real cracking match. What way will it turn? Where will the twist go? Ivaldi, line out taken, stolen from Pina. He's going to look to kick, but he can't get his kick away in time. And Montpellier are going to turn this over here, are they? It's looking dire here for Ulster. They've lost the position. Oh, that is disappointing. Turning the ball over. Here's Mouse giving it to Polisi. Montpellier do well in the ruck once again. They go to the left side now through Ranger. Good tackle from Bow. Oh, lucky not to get penalised there as Mouse goes into touch. Good tackle. Very good tackle. And it gives a line out. Short three-man line out. Interesting call here. And Best will throw in. One jumper. Pinar. He'll kick. Off the back of the line out. The wind is a bit of a swirler. It's taken nicely. And it's given away. Oh, good pass too coming in for Gamino. And he takes it up towards halfway. Ulster dedicating a lot of players again. Giving it away to Figalo this time. Now to Tinian. Driving into the tackle. But again, Ulster dedicating half their squad there to that tackle. Lisi straight to Trunduk and straight to smashing tackle. Pinar's turned him over. This is a chance. Trimble. Marshall pops it back for Payne. Looks on field. Can't get away. Good cover defense coming in. Pinar again picks it up quickly. Henderson. No way through the midfield for the big lock. And oh, turned over as well. Oh, Montpellier are all over this match at the moment. They go wide for the danger man.
Not releasing.
The Goose, not releasing again. And that's a couple of mistakes now from him. Not releasing in the tackle. And this is a chance here for Ulster. Boy, they need this. They need a try before the 70th minute. That is the key. And they can concentrate 10 minutes and any extra time to really launch at this Montpellier defence. His Best throws again, three-man line out. Pinar, Pinar, Pinar will score for Ulster. Spectacular play off the short line out, throwing the dummy. No one knew where he was going. He went straight to the line. Ruan Pinar, we say experience coming out his ears. It flows in this Ulster team, and this Ulster team flows through Ruan Pinar. Great try from the scrum half. That was the play. That was why they went for the short line out, and it worked. An absolute treat. It's an easy play. It's a simple play. It's basic as you like. But when you have dangerous men out in your back line, it's really a big lure to keep them wide. Looked like they were running on. And a big call, big try, big play from a big, big game player. Pinar with a chance to convert as well. He's been on song with the boot. Oh, that is spectacular. Ruan Pinar is really leading the charge here for Ulster. They are one try away. They have 11 minutes. Montpellier now. Oh, they need to score twice. They need to be the next team to score. The kick from Trunduk is very high. Oh, brilliantly taken from Muller.
Release.
But he's going to struggle to hold on. Ulster, their play at the back of the rucks has not been good. Their ball dedication as it's taken through the middle. Release. For Oliver. Maybe some ball coming here for Ulster. It is. This is good for Ulster. Here's Trimble. Ferris. He's still got a couple of men with him. It's Bow. Oh, this is a big chance here. He's got Marshall. Oh, the pass is woeful. The pass is shocking. Maybe the kick was a better option. We'll never know. But those two-on-ones. Oh, so dangerous. And the chance is blowing. Ivaldi goes to the man at the front, it's Hamilton. Oh, that looked forward. Wedrago goes through the centre of the line now, just about. Oh, but Ulster are on him too, and they've turned him over. This is another chance here, Payne. Oh, we just got rid of that far too quickly. Back inside for Marshall, outside to Pinar, keeping this ball alive. Doyle, Doyle split the line. Now's a big chance, into touch, as it is into touch, and another blowing chance. As Williams trying to run back to get that ball, steps into touch. Well, this is dying moments here. This will be the last play. Time is pretty much up. Here's Evaldi. He's taken at the front from Hamilton again. They'll drive on Hamilton. Ulster won't want him to go out though. How much will Montpellier want to play here? Chanduk gets the man running on. Oh, big clothesline coming in from Miller. And the captain's in a bit of strife here. That is a poor play. Montpellier will tap surely. They can't kick it out. Chanduk, he's got it and he taps. He uses his back, he goes to the left. Oh, they're going wide to Ranger. Ranger's looking good, but he's in touch, and that will spoil Ulster's party. They'll win the match, but now they're under immense pressure to get the points against Treviso. They couldn't finish it. They were desperate for their fourth try. They had multiple chances, and they'll look back at their match and say just before halftime was when it had to happen. Montpellier fall short. They were valiant in their efforts. But in the end, it was more about how many tries they scored rather than who actually won. Nagusa was outstanding in the first half for Montpellier. He was outstanding. He set up. That's why they led. Simply from Nagusa. Two tries for him. Chanduk converting one, giving them their 12 points. Of course, Ulster really come alive in that middle period of the second half. They got three tries throughout the match. Ruan Pienaar with an outstanding one from the short line out. Trimble, well, he was put away with a good pass from Payne. If only Bowen Marshall could have done that late on down the other end, it could have been four tries for them. Marshall did get the first try of the match as well. That was their third try. Pienaar was flawless with the boot. He was flawless throughout the match. He was outstanding, but he couldn't get them that fourth try. They got the win. Is that going to be enough? We're going to have to look at other pools as well and see if we're going to be even in close to being that top place, second place team. Let's have a look at the results from the pool. Let's see how the Tigers went and what we have to look forward to for the final round against Treviso, where we just have to smash them. Pure and simple. The full-time stats, just about forgot about these. Possession, fairly evenly mixed, as well as territory. Handlingers, Ulster made a pile 10. That is huge. Line breaks 9-6. Ulster come good in that second half. And that was really all we had. One scrum in the whole match. That's interesting. 10 handlingers, yet one scrum. Good stuff. 21-12. Ulster win. Now let's see what happens with the table. Okay, so the fixtures of note from round 5 is Montpellier going down to Ulster, 21-12, and the Leicester Tigers smashing Treviso, 36-10. That is the big gap there. That was a 5-pointer there for the Tigers, and that is where they needed to reply Ulster. They only got 4 points, and that puts them one behind the Tigers. But here we got the first match from round 6 for the Tigers. Oh my goodness, a boil over! An absolute boil over here. Montpellier upsetting the Leicester Tigers. 25-19. 6-point win, that gives the Tigers a bonus point. That should make the gap 2 points. Oh, Montpellier have done Ulster a massive favour here. You wouldn't read about it. Let's have a look. Oh, it's a 2-point game. Ulster just need to beat Treviso, the bottom place side, who are yet to register a win. They can win by 1 point or 100 points, it doesn't matter. They just need the win. Oh, what a turnaround. I really thought the Tigers would have won that by 4 points. They would have put them on, what, we're giving them another 3, so 22. Oh, this is really teed up nicely. This gives Ulster the game advantage, really. They just need to beat Treviso. If the Tigers only got 4, the win over Montpellier, they would have had to win by 5 points. Well, they would have had to win and get the 5 points with 4 tries. If the Tigers beat Montpellier by 4 tries or more, it would have been all over. Ulster wouldn't have been able to win the pool. So unbelievable, unbelievable turn of events here with the Tigers going down to third place Montpellier, who are out of the competition now. But what's a parting blow from Montpellier. 2 points in it. Wow, that's interesting. Other pools, if anyone is interested. Pool 6, Munster and Perpignan. Oh, that's another close one. Results could go anywhere there. Ospreys and Leinster lead pool 1. That one's pretty much sewn up there. And it's actually complete. So that is Ospreys who will qualify from pool 1. Pool 2, Toulon have qualified. Wow. 30 points for them, 6 from 6, 198 points difference. Glasgow Warriors take second with 16. That won't be enough for them to qualify at all, but a good effort. Cardiff Blues next to the Chiefs rounding out their pool. And Toulouse, the winners from pool 3, Saracens, just 2 points behind on 22. That will be close for them. Clermont taking out pool 4, Scarlets there, right behind them. But that'll be Clermont easily. It looks like Saracens here in pool 3 will be favourites to go through. Of course, if Ulster win, that means the Tigers will be only on 19. They won't be a favourite second place team getter either, because 22 from Saracens. And we're back to pool 6. Wow. Oh, that's interesting. That is very interesting. How's this season going to go? 6 pools, that means there must be quarterfinals. I'm unsure. Let's have a look at the fixture. There is quarterfinals, so a little bit different to the usual. So there it is, round 6. Treviso at home to Ulster. They just need 2 points to secure the top place in the pool. And that one will be coming to you very soon. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed the match today. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe if you want to see more Heineken Cup. And I'll see you all next time for the final pool match. And hopefully it won't be the last. Well, no, surely won't. There's quarterfinals. So that means Ulster all but secured a spot in the next round. So stay tuned for that, and I'll see you all next time. Until then, take care.